In this lesson, we will learn a different way of creating 3D models called polygonal modeling. Up until now, our models were made out of many separate objects. But from now on, we will try to create models using the least possible elements. So let's dive right in. Let's create one of the least complicated polygonal models, a stone. We will start as usual from the box. So let's tap the plus button and add a box. We want our stone to be more flat, so we could just scale it one of the axes, activate the scale gizmo, and let's scale it in the X axis. Now we would like to modify the geometry of our stone a bit. To do that, let's enter the vertex editing mode. Tap the operations popover and let's select the vertex tab. Close this popover by clicking on the operations button again. Here we are presented with all the vertices that build our box. We can select any vertical and move it just like it was a normal object. So let's select our first vertical, switch to the move gizmo, and let's move it a bit. Let's select another vertical and let's move it a bit. Now let's rotate around. Let's select another vertical, move it, rotate around, move it. We have no many possibilities to create a stone out of just 8 vertices. So it would be very nice to add a vertical on the longest edge we can see here. To do that, let's open the Operations tab and let's switch to the Edge tab. We can't just tap on the edge and add a vertical. Instead, we need to create an edge loop around the selected edges. You can imagine the edge loop being a thread that ties around the object. The result of tying the selected edges will be new edges and vertices. Close the popover right now. Let's select the edges we want our thread to tie around. Let's open the operations popover. Let's select Insert Edge Loop. Here we are. Now let's switch to the vertex sublevel. And let's modify our new vertices. Select one, move it a bit. Select another one, move it a bit. Select this one, move it a bit. Let's rotate around, select this one, and move it a bit. Select those two on the top, move them a bit up. And here we have a really beautiful stone right now. One advice here. When you model polygonal objects, try to work with as few polygons and vertices as possible, because the model will look more polished and editing it would be much, much faster. Let's now duplicate our object. So let's open the Operations tab, switch to Objects tab, and let's tap Duplicate. Now let's move our new object, activate the Scale gizmo, and scale this object. Let's move it a bit down and let's create another duplicate. Open the operations popover and select duplicate again. Let's move the new objects in the new place. Let's scale it a bit again. We can rotate it as well. And let's rotate this previous object as well, maybe in another axis. And let's move it. Now we have a really nice composition of a few stones.